This is Congressman Sarbanes. It's great to be with you. I wanted to take a few minutes to share some really good information about the Biden administration's overhaul of the Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program, which the Department of Education, U.S. Department of Education, recently announced just earlier this month. And this addresses issues that have been really impeding public servants' opportunity to benefit from student loan forgiveness. This is something that they relied on, that they deserve, and we want to make sure that this opportunity for loan forgiveness is available to them, and the Biden administration is working very hard to make sure that that's the case. I have a stake in this because back in 2007, a long time now, I authored the original legislation which created the Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program. We did this because we know that public service workers are generally and traditionally paid less than their private sector counterparts. And we also know, of course, that student loan debt is a very significant burden for many, many individuals and their families across the country. It can impact a borrower's ability to buy a house, as well as save for emergencies, for retirement. It has a huge impact. And the Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program promised that there would be this forgiveness of loans for qualified workers who were interested in and willing to pursue a career in public service, where maybe the salaries are lower than what they could get in the private sector. So it was a really important opportunity to provide to people, and we were glad to get the program in place originally. Unfortunately, it has struggled to live up to the promise. Some of you who've tried to access this program know that there have been real impediments, and that has affected teachers, it's affected first responders, health professionals, civil servants, other nonprofit sector jobs that would qualify for this forgiveness if the program was working well. And so we absolutely have got to make sure we fix what's broken in this program. We're working very hard to do that. The Biden administration is committed to it in Congress. We're certainly going to keep a close eye on those efforts to make sure that the promise is delivered and to eliminate these glitches, these bottlenecks that we've seen in the program. And this overhaul that the Department of Education is undertaking right now, it would make it easier to navigate the system. That's really important, and make sure that that student loan forgiveness is available to public servants who've relied on it and who deserve it. And I'm thrilled to have with me today as my guest, Mike Pierce, who is the executive director of the Student Borrower Protection Center. Welcome, Mike. Mike was on my staff when we passed the program back in the day, and I know how passionate he is about it. He's been working on this for years. He's excited as well about the opportunities to strengthen the program and to fix what's broken with the program right now. And I know he's looking forward to those efforts as we move ahead. I'm going to hand it over to Mike. He's going to cover some of the updates in the program. And after that, I'm going to ask him a couple of questions that I know are ones that come up frequently, and we can get some good answers from him. So, Mike, turning it over to you.
Thank you so much, Congressman. And thank you again for the chance to join today. I am going to share my screen now. And we have a little bit of information to cover here. I'm mostly going to talk today about this new opportunity for lots of folks that work in public service to be able to qualify that hadn't historically been able to qualify. But before I jump into the weeds, I just wanted to say thanks to the Congressman for the chance to be able to join you guys today. Congressman Sarbanes and Senator Kennedy 14 years ago had a vision for providing debt relief to student loan borrowers working in public service. That was really a pretty radical concept at the time. I think everyone realizes now that the student debt crisis affects people's lives, the economy, our society. But at the time, it was really a pretty novel proposition that the government should use its might to help support people that are struggling with student debt, particularly public service workers. I also should note that I'm from the district. I'm a lifelong Baltimorean, and I am really happy to be able to be here to be able to talk about the impact that public service loan forgiveness is going to have on our federal workforce, on Maryland's public service workforce. And I think that that is really all to the Congressman's credit. And so it's great to be able to be here. It's great to be able to finally deliver on the promise of this program after more than 14 years of fits and starts. And so with that, I'm going to jump into the weeds. So public service loan forgiveness, as Congressman Sarbanes mentioned, it is the largest student loan repayment option for borrowers who work in public service, the largest debt relief option for borrowers who work in public service. As much as a quarter of the U.S. workforce actually works for a public service employer within the definition of this program. To be able to qualify, you need to work for any 501c3 nonprofit, any government agency, whether that's a federal, state, local government, or a branch of the armed services. You would need to work for any other private nonprofit organization that provides public service, and that's defined in a couple of different ways, but that includes other private nonprofit employers that are providing public health or public interest law or social work or library services. There's a bunch of other specific classes of people that qualify as public service employers. And if you work in that quarter of the US workforce and you meet these other requirements, you have a right to have your debts canceled after 10 years of public service work. And I'm going to talk very quickly about what these requirements are, but then I'm going to spend the bulk of this presentation talking about how most of these requirements are being waived for borrowers working in public service as a result of this executive action that Joe Biden has taken. So I am going to talk a little bit about this right at the top. You need to make sure that you do have the right type of loan, the right type of repayment plan. I mentioned the types of employments that qualify. And you have to do all of these things for 120 months. So you have to do this for 10 years, making payments every month. And the rules for what kind of loan qualifies, what kind of repayment qualifies, all of these things have now been waived by the Biden administration for the special opportunity that lasts just a year to be able to give all of these public service workers in the system credit for their service. And this was the result of a really extraordinary effort by advocates and individual borrowers and elected officials to try to get the public service loan forgiveness program to live up to its potential. The other important thing that I want to flag at the top is that during COVID, most student loan borrowers haven't actually had to make a payment, but all of that time student loan payments have been suspended going back all the way to March of 2020. That all counts towards public service loan forgiveness. And so even though you haven't had to pay because of the pandemic, as long as you've been working in public service, those months count towards public service loan forgiveness. So now I'm going to talk a little bit about what got us here, why Joe Biden felt the need to take this emergency executive action to help public service workers. And then I'll talk about how you can actually qualify. So as Congressman Sarbanes mentioned, there has been some real problems with this program almost since the inception of it. The Education Department in the Bush administration wrote rules for the program that blocked a lot of people from accessing it. Over the course of the next two administrations, and particularly under Betsy DeVos, the Education Department mismanaged the program. Its contractors lied to borrowers. And we've seen in the headlines, by the time Joe Biden got into office, 98%, 99% of all people who have applied have been rejected. And in those headlines are beneath those headlines are stories of teachers and nurses and firefighters who did everything right and were lied to and were cheated out of their rights and were left in this place where they found themselves deeply in debt despite a decade of service. And where that brings us is this moment back over the summer where Education Secretary Cardona and President Biden, in response to calls from members of Congress led by Congressman Sarbanes, in response to calls from large international unions, including the American Federation of Teachers and the National Education Association, finally decided to start listening to borrowers. And so the administration back in July asks the public, what should we do to fix this? How do we fix this mess? 50,000 public service workers from across the country responded, shared their stories, talked about how the promise of public service loan forgiveness had been broken and demanded to get credit for their time serving in our community, serving on the front lines of the pandemic. And where that left us was a mandate for change. We saw earlier this month, Secretary Cardona and President Biden took a huge sweeping executive action to try to restore the promise of public service loan forgiveness. I'm going to spend a couple of minutes talking about what that executive action entails, what you need to know to be able to qualify for public service loan forgiveness. And then I'm going to walk very quickly through the steps to get on track. I'm not going to spend a lot of time with each step. All of the information I'm going to walk through today is going to be available on our website too. That's protectborrowers.org. It'll all live at protectborrowers.org/PSLF. But we are going to be putting out a bunch of materials to help people connect the dots here, not just these slides, but also some frequently asked questions and some other resources. So what just happened? I mentioned at the top of this presentation that you need to do four things to get on track for public service loan forgiveness. You need to have the right type of loan, be in the right type of repayment plan, work for a public service organization, and then do all three of those things every month for 120 months. What Joe Biden just did is waive a lot of these requirements. So now, for the first time, it doesn't matter what kind of loan you have. You used to have a federal direct loan, but now if you have an older federal loan that was made by a bank or another private lender, those can count. If you have a federal loan made through the Perkins Loan Program by your school, those can count. And not only do those loans count, but anytime you've been working in public service for the duration of your career, going back to 2007, those months in public service count. And to get credit for those, you have to do what's called consolidate. And I'll talk a little bit more about that. It's basically refinancing your old loans with a new direct loan and doing that specifically with the purpose of pursuing the special waiver. It sounds very complicated. It is a little bit complicated, but it means that if you can connect the dots, you're going to be able to be entitled to debt relief that was not available to you as recently as 4 weeks ago. It is not completely automatic. That's a really important thing that I want to emphasize. There is action that you're going to have to take, particularly if you have one of those older loans that wouldn't otherwise qualify. And again, I'm going to talk about what steps you have to do to get there. If you already did take an older loan and turn it into a direct loan, so lots of people since 2007 have, quote, consolidated their loans into the direct loan program. Many of them are public service workers, and they did it to get on track for public service loan forgiveness. That part's automatic. Once you've taken that step, the education department is going to go back and look at your student loan. And for everybody that brought one of those older, otherwise unqualifying loans into the direct loan program, anytime going back to 2007, the education department is going to look back and is going to count your payments no matter what payment plan you were enrolled in. If you were in the military, they'll count periods of military deferment and forbearance. If you've made late payments or if you paid less than you owed on your bill, you're going to get credit for those months as well. And actually, on a Friday night a couple of weeks ago, the first borrower started to get emails from the Department of Education saying that their payment counts were being updated. And they were getting contacts from their student loan servicer saying, we are now in a place where you now get an extra 10 months or an extra 20 months, or you've qualified for public service loan forgiveness. So the first of those automatic steps are happening right now. But for borrowers that still have those older loans, loans made through the Perkins program or loans made through the FFEL or Federal Family Education Loan Program, those are the loans that are made by banks and other private lenders back before 2010. You do have to take action. Importantly, there's a deadline for you to take action. Because this executive action to fix PSLF was done as part of a response to the coronavirus pandemic, there's a limited opportunity here. You have to take that action and consolidate your loans by the end of October next year. So we have just a bit more than a year to get this done, to find every single borrower in this country who works in public service and who has one of these older loans and get them to take the steps they need to take. There are some other tricks and traps that I wanted to warn you about, some things you should be aware of along the way. As of right now, loans through the Parent Plus program do not count. We would love to hear from you if you have a parent loan and you work in public service. You should go to protectborrowers.org and reach out to us. We're in communication with the Biden administration, continuing to push for everyone that has student debt that works in public service to get credit here. But as of right now, only people that have loans that they took out for their own education, whether that's undergrad or grad school, those count, but parent borrowers do not. The student loan service the student loan servicing industry has been messing this program up for 14 years. We are relying on the very same companies that messed this up in the first place to finally do right by public service workers. So it's really important to know the steps you need to take and what your rights are, because there is still a lot of bad information out there. There's also some potential for some red tape and some crossed wires with the process of taking those steps to make those older loans into new direct loans to get started. And then the last thing that I would warn everybody about, and I'm sure you've read this in the headlines, is that a number of student loan companies are quitting. The government's two largest student loan contractors are walking away from their jobs at the end of the year. And so there's going to be a little bit of confusion, and there's going to be a lot of transition that's going to happen right at the same time as the special opportunities available for public service workers. We're going to help people try to navigate that mess. There are lots of folks that are really committed membership organizations that represent public service workers, the labor movement, advocates like us that are really committed to helping people connect these dots and make sure that everybody qualifies. But it's going to take a lot of work. Now I'm going to spend a few minutes talking about some practical advice on what borrowers need to know. And I'm going to offer a few examples of the step-by-step process of taking advantage of the special opportunity for people that have the kinds of loans that have not qualified until now. And I did want to say part of the reason why this is so important is that when public service loan forgiveness was first created, most borrowers had loans that didn't qualify. And when Congressman Sarbanes created the program, everyone assumed that public service workers would have an easy path to take this couple of simple steps at the very start of their careers. And no one expected the student loan industry to lie to borrowers about what their rights are. And nobody expected the Bush administration to set up a bunch of procedural hurdles that made it nearly impossible for people to get on track. What we ended up with, these 99% denial rates a decade later, was a surprise. It was not really the design of the program. It was just the implementation of it. And yet here we are. And so now we have this special opportunity for people that have been in this system for 14 years, that have those kinds of loans that were the most common loan back when these programs were created, to actually get credit for their service and to deliver the promise for public service loan forgiveness. And so with that, I want to jump into the mechanics a little bit. There are a few action steps for those borrowers, particularly for borrowers who have an older federal loan. And so you should do a little bit of a checkup to figure out if it's worth it for you to take these steps. And if you work in public service, and if you have these older federal loans, then it is certainly worth it for you. So the first thing you need to do is check up on what kind of loans you have, and I'll talk about how to do that. Then you need to check up to make sure that your employer is a qualified public service employer, and I'll show you how to do that. And then you have to certify your service. You have to tell the federal government how long you've been working in public service so they can count the right number of payments and they can cancel your debt. So what loans do you have? If you have a direct loan, so it's a loan made by the U.S. Department of Education, this is the kind of student loan that basically everyone who went to school since July 1st, 2010 has. So if you're a more recent public service worker, if you've only been in school since July of 2010, you almost certainly have a direct loan and there's really nothing else you need to do. But if you have a loan that was made before 2010, you have to consolidate. You have to take these steps to be able to get on track. To do that, you also have to make sure that you have a public service employer. I talked about this at the very top, but I'm going to walk through how you actually do this. There's a tool on the U.S. Department of Education's website that's very good. It's brand new, and it helps you look up a registry from a registry of all the public service employers that there's records of at the Education Department. And so you can actually match your employer with the Education Department's database, make sure you're on track. And then the last thing you need to do is fill out the forms to document the time that you've spent in public service. And again, I'm going to walk very quickly through how you do that. There are some examples of the step-by-steps in this presentation that I am going to go through very quickly, but will be available afterwards so you can take your time with it and you can make sure that you're making all the right choices. So the first step is identifying your student loans. If you go to studentaid.gov, and you have to have a password for this, so if you don't have an FSA ID, it's what the credentials called for that website, you have to request one. It's all electronic. It's very easy. It only takes a couple days for them to process it, but it is the first step, is making sure you can actually go to the Department of Education's website and log in. Once you've logged in successfully, you can go to view details under your student aid dashboard and download your information about your student loans. And this is really only something you need to do if you don't know what type of student loan you have. Your student loan bill might say you have an FFEL loan or federal family education loan or Stafford loan or Perkins loan. There's lots of words that might send you in the right direction. You can skip the step if you know what kind of loan you have. But if you don't, this is the way you can be certain. Once you pull your information from the education department's website, you'll see this description here. And you'll see the phrase FFEL, or you'll see Perkins written down there. And you know this is a loan that you have to take these extra steps to get on track. There are some other keywords here, some other ways you can tell. The slide deck has more information. I won't go into it, but there's a step-by-step here. So you have determined that you have a loan where you need to consolidate. This is an important action step. This is the key difference maker between getting on track to get credit now and taking advantage of the special opportunity and missing out on potentially having your debts canceled right away. For you to do that, you go right back to the same website that we just logged in to look at your student aid account. And under the Manage Loans tab, there's a dropdown and an option to consolidate my loans. And again, this involves a bunch of steps. People get knocked off track, but this is the super simple version of it. And we will have this information available for you also. Once you log in and you consolidate your loans, there's an application. We have a step-by-step guide here on all the information that you need to enter and the steps that you need to take to be able to get on track. You can pick your student loan servicer that's going to handle your account once you've consolidated your loans. Fed Loan Servicing, or FIA, has been the company that's been responsible for the Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program. That's what it's going to prompt you to pick. They are one of the companies that are quitting their jobs at the end of the year. I'm not sure how much it actually matters which company you pick at this point. We're going to continue to have updates on our website as the Education Department provides more guidance for public service workers. But as of right now, we're recommending that people do pick Fed Loan Servicing because they are, as of today, the company that handles public service workers. You also have to pick a payment plan. For borrowers that have been working in public service for more than a decade, it's likely that your loans are just going to be canceled outright and you'll never have to pay a bill on these loans. But they are going to make you pick a payment plan. Picking the plan that offers you the lowest monthly payment is often in people's financial interest. For most public service workers, that's the revised pay-as-you-earn plan or repay. There are lots of options here, but I do think that it is best to enroll in one of the payment plans that lets you pay based on your income. You'll get a chance to review all of the information that you provided, and then you'll have to sign the forms. And once you sign those forms, this will get processed. It should get processed in a couple of weeks, and that puts you on a glide path towards getting your debts canceled. And I'll talk about the couple of extra steps you need to take, but that's the key one. If you do that immediately, you will be on track to get as much credit as you've earned by the end of October of next year. The couple of other steps, and again, I'm not going to spend a lot of time with this, but there's a tool here I mentioned before to look up who your public service employer is. Again, if you go to the Manage Loans tab, you can pick Public Service Loan Forgiveness, and there's lots of good resources on studentaid.gov, including a bunch of the information I've already shared. But on that page is the PSLF help tool, and that will let you add an employer and use your employer's employer identification number, or EIN. It's the number that identifies your employer to the IRS. It should be on your W-2. It should also be on your paychecks, potentially. And you'll be able to match your employer with the Education Department's database. And if you note the period of time that you've worked in public service for that employer, and you find that employer matched, and you select the match, and you process the form, what it's actually going to do is generate a pre-populated piece of paper that you can have your employer sign to certify your employment. So this is a really easy way to make sure that you're on track and make sure that you have the right kind of employer. It's also a really easy way to get the kind of paperwork you need completed. And then you can actually put yourself in the queue to get credit for public service loan forgiveness. I know this seems complicated. I know this is a lot of steps. I promise you, if you go through these slides on a step-by-step basis, it's actually quite simple. It really only takes you 15 or 20 minutes. And at the end of that process, you're on track to get your loans canceled or to get credit for all the time you spend in public service if it's been less than 10 years. So the most important takeaways, I know I covered a lot of material. I know I used a lot of jargon, and I know that this stuff can be very confusing and overwhelming for public service workers. But the important things to know are, because of Joe Biden and this executive action that Congressman Sarbanes and many other members have been pushing for, any public service worker in this country that has a federal student loan can get credit for their service. This is the first time that's ever been possible, and it is only possible until the end of October of next year. So we have a year to make sure that every single public service worker in America that has student debt can get credit for their service, and if they've been working for a decade, get their debts canceled. But you have to confirm what type of loan you have and take this extra set of steps if you have a loan that wouldn't otherwise qualify. You have to confirm to the government who your employer is and that is an employer that qualifies. You have to certify your service. So you have to tell the government how long you've been working in public service. And you have to do all of those things. Potentially by the end of October, there's some open questions and we can talk about them in the Q&A about how many of these steps or what steps need to be finished or whether if you've just started this process, that's enough. These are all questions the Education Department hasn't answered yet, but that we're hearing from public service workers. But if something goes wrong, if something doesn't seem right, there are places where you can file a complaint and you can get help. The place that we like to send everybody is to the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. They are the federal regulator for all of the Education Department's contractors. And so if your student loan company tells you something that doesn't seem right, consumerfinance.gov is the best place to go with a complaint about a student loan company. The Education Department also takes complaints directly from student loan borrowers at studentaid.gov. It's another drop down on the same website we've been showing you screenshots at for the past 20 minutes. And with that, Congressman, I'm happy to answer any questions.
Thanks very much, Mike. That was terrific. I'm very excited about the steps that the Biden administration is taking to overhaul the program and overcome some of these impediments that we've seen in place. And you gave it a really outstanding overview of that. So I very much appreciate that. I would like to throw a few questions at you that we collected from people. So the first question I got was, the Department of Education previously disqualified some of my payments. Can I appeal that decision under the new PSLF changes? And if so, how do I do it?
So the good news is it might happen automatically. Tens of thousands of people got emails from the Education Department beginning 2 weeks ago with new payment count information, updating their student loan records and giving them credit for lots of payments that weren't counted previously. First thing you should do is to go into your student loan account and check to make sure that that payment count is still off, because for lots of people, it's already been updated and it's been updated automatically. For folks whose payment count still seems off, there are other steps you can take. One thing you can do is submit a complaint directly to the Education Department through their website at studentaid.gov. Another step that you can take is to go back through and make sure that you have certified every period of service that you've completed. And so if you have not submitted one of those employer certification forms for a period of your public service, you should go back through and do that now. And that will trigger an update of payment counts. The other thing that we do hear from people is that they have appeals with their student loan servicer, with Fed Loan Servicing, that haven't been processed, like a request for an account audit. That's a good reason to file a complaint with the Education Department. That company is leaving. It's not going to be your student loan servicer by the end of the year. And so it's really important that you have kept as many records as you can and that you've shared those records with the Department of Education directly. You can download all of your correspondence with your student loan servicer on your loan servicer's website. For folks that have Fed Loan as a servicer, it's in your student loan account where you go to pay your bill every month.
Great. Thanks very much. Here's another question. One borrower says, I have Parent PLUS loans. Will I be eligible for forgiveness under the temporary expansion of PSLF?
So the short answer is, as of right now, the Biden administration has not announced plans to help parent borrowers get on track here. That's a place where we have been told they want to hear from parent borrowers, and they may still reach the decision that parent borrowers deserve the same rights as everybody else. That's certainly our organization's position, and we're pushing as hard as we can. As of right now, this special opportunity only applies to loans that were taken out to pay for you to go to college, not to pay for a dependent to go to college, but that very well may change over the next couple of months.
Got it. Here's another one. I'm an educator and was told I did not qualify for the Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program because I didn't work for a qualifying employer. Can I qualify now?
Depending on where you're an educator, you should have already qualified. We actually published some information that we got from the Education Department that showed that thousands of teachers across the country have been wrongfully rejected for public service loan forgiveness. They certified that they worked for a school district that should have qualified and they were told that they didn't. So we'd encourage anybody that works, particularly if you work for a public school district, but even if you teach in a private school, to certify your service again and to get a second look at your decision, because there were a lot of mistakes made, particularly early in the program. And now that you can go to this PSLF help tool and actually pre-populate your employer certification form with information about your current employer, it speeds the process up. So my recommendation is to just go back and certify your service again. You should qualify.
And lastly, a question came in. I work as a nurse and I tried to make one-time payments towards forgiveness. The process was confusing and often I received wrong information about my status in the program. What will be done under the new program to ensure loan servicers are providing accurate information to borrowers?
So the Biden administration has really approached this from a couple of different directions. One of the first things that President Biden did when he came into office was hire my old boss, the former director of the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, to be the top student loan official at the Education Department. He's a former state attorney general and a really fierce advocate for student loan borrowers. And he's made it very clear to the student loan industry that the kinds of abuses and deception that were really, really common in the past are not going to be tolerated anymore. So some of this will work out in a way that the level of service being provided to student loan borrowers is going to improve. The other answer to that question is a lot of these things are going to be automatic now. So the Biden administration is also writing new rules for the Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program moving forward that's going to take a lot of the administrative burden off of public service workers like nurses and teachers, and the government's going to do it for you. And so there will obviously be a continued need to be really diligent and to make sure that you're on track and to take the steps you have to take. But a lot of that stuff, particularly things like what payment plan and counting payments, it's going to get easier. The system is going to get better. And a lot of that will happen automatically for you.
Right. Well, obviously the path is being cleared substantially for borrowers to access this forgiveness opportunity. I want to thank you for your incredible expertise in this area and being such a resource today. I think this can be a terrific toolkit for borrowers who've been very frustrated. We hope that the people on the call today will share it, and we're going to certainly make this available going forward. This video is going to be available on my YouTube channel and on my website. And I believe and I hope that this overhaul at the Department of Education is going to make a huge difference in the lives of student borrowers who've relied on this promise of opportunity with respect to loan forgiveness. I'm certainly going to continue to work on the issue, as I know you are, Mike, watching these changes as they go into effect and making sure that they're implemented in a way that meets the expectations of our student borrowers. And please, to everyone on the call, everyone who watches this video, contact my office if you have any questions, and we'll provide feedback along the way. Obviously, Mike and his organization are available, and many of the resources that he identified during his presentation are extremely valuable. So thanks everybody for joining in. Have a great evening.